Shikshak is giving a best platform for students. Their way of approach really interests. They're giving much space to the teachers as well as students. Being a part of Shikshak, I feel very proud to say this. And all the best students, this is the best platform to start your musical journey. This is Malladi Swati. I'm from a musical family, and my gurus are Sri Modhumudi Sudhakar Garu, top grade artist in All India Radio. And currently I'm learning from Neela Ram Gopal, topmost artist in Bangalore, very senior artist. I have done my MA music from Andhra University, and I have a gold medal for my academic excellence. And I'm a graded artist from All India Radio. I have B high grade in Carnatic Classical and A grade in Light Music. And I got many awards and prizes since my childhood. I attended, and I got a central government merit scholarship in junior level and senior level as well. And I gave many performances. Since 10 years, I'm in this teaching field. I trained so many students. Some of my students completed their diploma courses, and few students are going for the exams, MA exams. And I'm teaching online classes as well since 7 years. For music, there is no age limit, sir. As of me, still I'm learning. I am very passionate in learning as well as in teaching. About the syllabus, I can divide this syllabus into 4 levels. That is basic level, junior level, senior level, and advanced levels. Basically, in first level, all the basics, it's an introduction of just about swara, shruti, laya, all these basic aspects for music. You can learn in this level. And in next level, junior level, in this level, a brief introduction of ragas, different ragas, and sahityam part will be introduced in this level, junior level. And in the senior level, the elaborated explanation of ragas. That means gamakas, how to give gamakas. That would be typical Carnatic classical gamakas. That is a separate session to learn, actually. That is a main course in Carnatic music. In that level, you have to learn varnas. From that, you can learn gamakas and different talas, different ragas. Has been introduced in this level very elaboratedly. And these gamakas and way of singing, all the gamakas are very, very important in Carnatic classical. After this level, that is advanced level, in that level, that is completely depends on your creative part. Creative part means Manodharma Sangeetam. You have to give your own ideas to the ragas. And at this level, it's a very vast subject. You can learn from everything by listening, by learning. Mostly that advanced levels, mainly you have to learn through listening only. These are all the 4 levels which we can start learn music from the basic level to advanced levels. And if it comes under syllabus, all these aspects are very common. Of course, different universities mention different compositions, but these levels are same in all the universities, whatever syllabus they have gone through. But name, the compositions will be different, but the levels won't be changed. So whatever which university they want to go through, everybody can follow that syllabus and they can learn in all these levels. Gharanas are not comes under Carnatic classical. That is a different genre of music. In Carnatic classical, we sing only from in basic level, sardi varse, janta varse, alankaras, Swarajatis, all these Swarapallavis, and Dhatu Varse, Hichustai and Tagustai, all these combinations of notes. These exercises will be there in basic level. And in the next level, Geetas. Geetas, Swarajatis, and Swarapallavis will be there in the, and few devotional items also you can learn at this level. And in the next senior level, Varnas. There are different talas in Varnas, Aditala Varnas and Atatala Varnas, Jampatala Varnas. So many varieties are there in the Varnas also. And in this level, after this, a small Kritis also you can learn in this level. And after that, Manodharma Sangeetam, which I said, it's a creative part. All the Kritis, big Kritis and small Kritis, Chaukakala Kritis, Madhyamakala Kritis. And you can learn how to sing Raga and Swarakalpana and Naraval, Ragantanam Pallavi. All these are all creative aspects. This will be in the advanced levels. All syllabus, everything will follow these only. But what, which Varnam they have to sing, which Kriti they have to learn, it depends on university to university or whatever it is. But this pattern out of this, nothing will be there. This is particularly for Carnatic music, I'm saying. I suggest my students to do some exercises to enhance their voice quality first. And next thing is and pronunciation. These two things are very, very important in for singers. For this particularly, there are some exercises. Definitely, I'll suggest my students according to their requirement. So few people have their voice clearly. That is the natural tendency of their voice. If the natural tendency of their voice is so clear, you need not do anything. For few people, they don't know their limitations in their voices. So for them, particularly, there are some few exercises to reach their maximum limit and to give their best output from their voice. I'll suggest definitely a few exercises for this. I know music therapy also. Accordingly, I'll try in their voice first, then only I'll start basics. There are so many universities and music colleges who are conducting these exams in junior level and senior level and MA and PhD. As per my knowledge, I've done MA music from Andhra University. They have their particular syllabus. They'll follow that and they'll teach. Once we enroll to the exams, they'll give the syllabus. Whatever the syllabus I told just now, I explained all the levels. In my, when I've done MA music, we have Ragantanam Pallavis, number of Varnas, and so many big Kritis and small Kritis, Vilambakala Kritis, and Ragalapana. All those advanced level aspects are there in the MA exams, as well as theory. And if once you enter into that university syllabus, then you can follow that. There is no specific, because everybody have their own syllabus. Every university will follow their own syllabus. We can't particularly point out here this one. If a student want to approach for an examination, first they need to choose a university or academy, whatever that is. And first they need to enroll there and take the syllabus. Whatever syllabus, which course they are going to do, that syllabus I can teach, whatever the university that it means, no problem. And theoretical aspects also, there are very common. There is music is universal, right? So there is nothing different will be there from university to university. Just we need to follow that syllabus. And all the whatever is there in the syllabus, theoretically or practically, everything you can learn according to the syllabus. My mother tongue is Telugu, but all the compositions will be there in Sanskrit. Most of the music compositions are there in Sanskrit and Telugu, as well as Tamil and Kannada. Everything is there. I don't know Tamil, but I can sing Tamil Kritis also. I've learned my guru Neela Ram Gopal Garu is from Tamil Nadu only. So I learned few kritis in Tamil, and as a Kannadiga now I'm staying in Bangalore, so I learned Kannada also, and I can teach Purandar Dasa as well. So that language is not a problem for music. Music has a, it's a universal language. Everybody can learn. And my medium of teaching is English only. For Telugu students, I can teach in Telugu. Laptops are good for this video interactions. It is very comfortable. And it's better to use headphones also to get more clarity. Sa ri ga ma pa da ni sa ta ni da pa ma ga ri. These kind of basics, almost 10 to 15 are there. Different combinations of these swaras. This is actually, it is in the same raga. All the basics will be in Maya Malava Gowda. The raga name is Maya Malava Gowda. And it is set to Adi Thalam. And our great composer, Purandara Vithala, Purandara Dasa. He has composed all the basics for the beginners. This is he gave a excellent path to start a music journey through the basics. In this, students has to learn different speeds also. Sa ri ga ma pa ma da pa sa ri ga ma. Sa ri ga ma pa ma da pa sa ri ga ma pa da ni sa ta ni da pa ma pa ga ma ta ni da pa ma ga ri sa sa ri ga ma pa ma da pa sa ri ga ma pa da ni sa sa ni da pa ma pa ga ma sa ni da pa ma ga ri sa. Like this, almost 15 are there basics in the different combinations with the same scale, that means same raga. In all the speeds they have to learn. I'll make my students to learn, particularly I want to focus on each and every note. The placements of notes are very, very important. At this level only, they have to start their singing in a proper way. That means with Shruti Shuddham and clarity and voice range, everything, Shruti, Laya, everything they have to concentrate at this level only. I'll concentrate on each and everything. And till they get, I don't leave them. I'll teach them till they have to, because it's just like alphabets. For children, we make them to write number of times A, B, C, D. Afterwards, they can write even sentences, words easily. The same way at this level, they have to, the placements of notes are very, very important. They need to sing in a proper way, with proper Shruti and Laya and so a proper Swarasthanas. In all these aspects, I'll concentrate for basic students, and I'll try to correct their voice also at this level, because for children, their voice is very tender and they need to, depends on person to person, I don't suggest for everyone, but they need to come up with their voice, work out on voice clarity also to improve their range and everything. I'll teach all these aspects while teaching basics. I recommend only Shruti Box to join the classes, particularly for vocal, because I'll teach vocal Carnatic music. So for that is a Shruti is a basic thing. Without Shruti, no student should not sing. That is my sincere request. Every student has to follow this. They have to carry their tambura while doing their practice as well as while learning. Whenever they want to sing, without tambura, they should not sing. It depends on them only. Every student have a different aspect. Actually, they learn in different way. Few students can understand easily and few people, they need a lot of practice. So we can't say that we can finish it in one class. For a few students, I have seen so many students. Currently, I have almost 18 students. So different level students I have seen. But every student has their unique quality in singing, as well as they have their own plus and minus. They need to concentrate on that minus more. It depends on that how many classes they can complete one session or one particular level. That we'll understand after listening to them only. I don't suggest particularly I can finish it in two classes or five classes. I'll teach Carnatic vocal only. In that aspect, I can teach light music also, but my language is Telugu. Particularly this light music, this is like Bhavagites. It's similar to some melody songs with lyrical values. So in that category also I can teach, but only in Telugu. And devotional I can teach. Music is not only to learn, you can enjoy it, and it gives a lot of happiness also. It relieves your stress. And the way of learning is very, very important. Everybody I request the students not to take it as a hobby. Take it seriously and try to enjoy it. Then you can sing better and you can try to improve yourself. First, try to improve your voice quality. And after that, concentrate on subject. I explained now already about all the levels. But every level is a challenge for every student. There are so many things to learn in every level. And you have to mold your voice to reach all the levels. Because range is very, very important. I have seen so many students struggling to reach all the ranges. For them, I have so many ideas and so many exercises. I'll suggest them, definitely. If you want to become a good singer, best singer, first you need to know how to sing. After that, you can concentrate on subject. Before starting your subject, you need to focus on your voice quality. And last but not the least, Shikshak is giving a best platform for students. Because their way of approach really I interest, because they're giving much space to the teachers as well as students. Their interaction is very, very good. And I enjoyed a lot being a part of Shikshak. I feel very proud to say this. And all the best students, this is the best platform to start your musical journey.